details, breaking news within the hour.
Lots going on, Micah and Joe. Tonight, a bombshell. After more than a decade as the Democratic leader of the Senate, President John Cullerton is retiring. He informed his colleagues tonight during a caucus meeting. Second, Mayor Lightfoot struck out. She wanted changes to the Chicago casino tax structure, but lawmakers called it quits before taking it up.
Tonight, lawmakers adjourned without approving Mayor Lightfoot's Chicago casino fix. But the man shepherding the bill in the House, Bob Rita, promises to try again next year.
We're going to continue to work.
When it became clear the legislature was not going to act, Chicago area lawmakers lashed out.
So there is nothing in this bill that would ensure that Chicago could develop and locate a thriving casino.
If the Chicago casino does not happen, it has very serious ramifications.
Tonight in a statement, Mayor Lightfoot said she'll keep trying. While we are disappointed that a much-needed fix to the gaming bill won't be made during this compressed veto session, the Chicago casino is still very much in the sight line thanks to the progress we've made with our state partners. In other news,
and the bill is declared passed.
Lawmakers approved Governor Pritzker's top priority during veto session, a plan to consolidate 650 downstate and suburban police and fire pensions.
This consolidation marks a vital step forward for our fiscal future.
The measure forms two new statewide investment pools, an effort to boost returns, and the governor says the legislation lowers costs. Also today, the legislature took a crack at ethics reform. Both the House and Senate passed a last-minute bill requiring more public disclosure from lawmakers and lobbyists. Baby steps, while a commission studies public corruption.
What's happening here is some window dressing, it's some wallpapering of a big, ugly, festering wound.
Mayor Lightfoot is not giving up on the casino fix, and neither is Governor Pritzker. His office said tonight he is committed to keep at it, working with city and other stakeholders. Mike and Joe.
Cullerton retiring, how much of a surprise was that?
Big shocker tonight. So who might replace him? It could be Kimberly Lightfoot's been there a while, Terry Link. But of course, there are people that are reporting he wore a wire. The Democrats are going to have to sort that out.
Yeah, definitely.
So what happens, too, with Mayor Lightfoot? I know we talked about it a little bit at 5 o'clock, but for folks who didn't hear it, what happens now? This isn't dead just yet.
Not dead just yet. They're going to try again in January. They'll try to see what they can come up with. She thinks that she's got a plan B going. She was able to refinance some debt, find some additional savings. So apparently there's not going to be a massive tax hike, but she's got to get the city council to go along with signing off on a budget that's going to account for something that won't happen until the spring.
Of course, the big question on Chicagoans' minds, that property tax.
That's what everyone wants to know. This doesn't help, certainly.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm.